In the previous video, we talked about minimum viable product. To be more precise, we actually deep dived into the concept of minimum viable product, right from what it is to its purpose, benefits, and 5 steps to build the one for your business. But something very important was dropped. Minimum viable product plays a very important role, especially for startups. The success of MVP defines the success of startups for the young entrepreneurs. Therefore, in today's video, I'm going to break down the 7 points you should remember while building MVP for your business. Keep watching. Before starting, let me tell you that these 7 points were part of the previous video itself, but that video was getting too longer and hence I cut it down and made another video out of it, so that it's much more easier to understand and break down the things. You may find my presence different from what I'm looking right now, but anyways, let's start with the video. The first thing is that MVPs are not meant to earn. Yes, I know businesses exist to earn and get profits, but MVPs are not meant for it. Remember the purpose of MVP. It was meant to get a better understanding of product, market, and customers, right? And if you want to earn from MVP, you just focus on earning feedbacks, not the money, not the profits. Remember that, because MVPs are not meant for it. MVPs are just for better understanding of the market, ideal product, and the customers. Remember that. Okay, so the second point. MVPs are not meant for startups.
But kya bol raha?
Yes, MVPs are not meant for startups. These are meant for every business out there. A startup may be creating MVP for its first product, whereas a unicorn company or an established company may be creating MVP for its 10th or 100th product. MVPs are very common in this business world, so don't associate with MVP with only startups. It is a term and it's a concept that's very much relevant to all other businesses as well. So that's what I wanted to tell you.
Sahi bol raha hai.
The third point, MVP and prototyping. Prototyping is a word that's very much confusing in itself, because it totally depends on the context it's being used. So here, by prototyping, I mean the designing or just thinking about your product and getting the first draft done. That's all what prototyping is known as, when you're actually putting efforts by sketching your product or maybe virtually creating it. That's what prototyping is known as, the very first draft of your product. That's what prototype is. Don't confuse it with MVP. MVP is a different thing and prototyping is a different thing. Prototyping can be a part of MVP, but definitely these two are different concepts. Don't mix them. The one is meant to create an actual product, whereas the other, the prototyping basically, is just meant to create the first draft of your product. Now the fourth point, MVP and the ideal product. A lot of times when MVP is very good, so what happens, the entrepreneurs start getting some initial profits, and some of them get distracted with the profits and they forget about upgrading their product for the ideal version. And that's, I do not want you to be doing. I want that you should have a separate line for your MVP and for your ideal product. Don't rely on that MVP. It's just meant to get feedbacks and understand the market, customers, and product, to hence build the ideal product. So the ultimate aim is to build that ideal product and not earn from this MVP. Remember that. Okay, so the fifth point is MVP and POC, proof of concept. It says that you got to do anything only when you have a validation, a very strong reason for that. And with respect to MVP, this says that you got to build MVP only when you feel like the problem is good enough, you have any kind of proof for that. So that's all this concept says. I found this while researching, so don't consider much about this POC, but I had to tell you because I promised to tell everything about MVP. So that's why I've covered this, and it's very obvious because the framework which I've told you, it's already starting from the problem, and there itself you will be getting validation for your business, for your problems. So it does not make any sense to you. Now the sixth and the final point, MVP, digital world, and service industry. I want to touch the relationship among them. Now, we all know that we are living in a digital world, a world of internet, a world that is changing very rapidly. Now, some of you may be thinking that MVP is all about making physical products, right? but that's not the correct way. You may not create an app or the website that's ideal digital product for you. You may just add only some of the features on the website or in the app and just think how that app actually gets the traction from the customers and all. So that's how MVP is definitely applicable for the digital world. That's what I wanted to tell you. Okay, so the other thing is MVP and service industry. Guys, in general, service industries do not make any products, right? Neither digital nor physical. So does MVP make sense there? Yes, it does make sense there. Maybe not the MVP, but the ideology behind MVP I told earlier, BML, build, measure, learn, definitely makes a sense in service industry as well. You do not need to carry out every service, and you just need to focus on the core services that offer the main values, the core values of your business, and later on you can expand your services or you can upgrade your services or you can change the style of your services. That totally depends. But the basic or the core version, you can start with that. For example, a garage can start focusing on its main service, that's repairing the cars, instead of modification of the cars. In the future, they can modify the cars, but at present, they can just start with the basic repair of the cars. Guys, these were the 7 points that I personally feel are very important to be aware of. Honestly, when I got to know about them, the clarity for MVP increased, and I hope the same applies to you as well. This video was all about this. Now, finally, MVP is done, and you know everything that's important to build the one for your business. In case you haven't checked the previous video that had the 5 steps to exactly build MVP for any business out there, check that out. And for this particular video, comment down your feedbacks and any thoughts you have with respect to Bean Dhruv channel. That would really help me. And share this video as well for everybody so that they can also start their business journeys. If you like reading, I'll link a blog in the description. Check that out. That will be all about MVP. And thanks for watching this video. We'll meet in the next video. Namaste.